8K high performance video processing, whether you are in the broadcast industry, in the entertainment industry, in the medical industry, there's so many different examples. And I'm here with Alexey Lopic. He's the director of engineering at Altera, and we're here at the Embedded World in Germany, and you have some great cases. But maybe you can explain how 8K high performance video processing is used in different type of use cases.
Yeah, so 8K or any high performance, high throughput video processing is really widely used in a great variety of applications. Let's start with even Olympics, right? It's going to be broadcast again in 8K and distributed. So all that pipeline and processing is quite challenging, starting from the video connectivity down to processing and then distribution across the world into our screens. That's just one example. Mm-hmm. Another example is, let's say, video projectors. They always come to the venues and see all those beautiful advertisements. So that's another one. Video walls and digital displays, all the concert shows, in fact, you just look around, all of them are, in fact, much more than 8K. In fact, even the cinema production nowadays using the replacement of the green screen with the real-time updated video walls. So the applications are enormous. But it's not just 8K, it's also 4K, 240 hertz, or some high-frequency components, or maybe mixing in the virtual reality, so application science.
And can you explain, because you have an input and an output, how is it really working? What's happening in between?
So, well, indeed, you're right. So the challenge starts with an input, so you need to have the interfaces capable of feeding that high data rate. And there are a number of interfaces like HDMI 2.1, DisplayPort 2.0. Then the challenge becomes how to actually process it. And the challenge of processing it, it becomes because there is so much data, you have to either process it really, really fast, or you have to use many resources in the FPGA to process that. And in this example, actually, our FPGA fabric enables it to process consistently above 600 megahertz, which allows us to process, say, for example, an 8K stream in a really compact way. And so you have all your usual video processing, like scaling, mixing, chroma sampling, down to a bit more advanced video processing IPs like tone mapping, 3D lookup table, or warp.
And for an example, you have distortion over here. Yeah. Can you describe how this works?
So first of all, the distortion really is, the application for the distortions are quite common. The most useful one is, for example, projectors. So if you want to project something onto the wall, you would have to use something like a keystone correction distortion. And so this image, which looks really skewed here, will look perfectly square on the screen. So that's just one example.
All in real time.
All in real time, all at 60 FPS, and yes.
And how can people that are in this industry can get started?
Actually, really, really easy. All the IPs are already within the Quartus software. In fact, there are example designs, and they just basically have to Google Warp IP FPGA, and hopefully the first or second link will be showing these IPs.
Great, and people can get started.
Let's get them started.
Thanks a lot.
No problem.
Thank you for watching here today from the Embedded World, from the Altera booth, with some other great FPGA examples.
Thank you.
Thank you.